Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the physiological anatomy of cardiac muscles. Let's get started. The cardiac muscles are basically of three types: atrial muscle, ventricular muscle, and excitatory and conductive muscle fibers. Atrial and ventricular muscles, as per their name, constitute the atria and ventricles respectively. They are the main contractile muscles in the heart. Let's see their overall structure in more detail. Individual cell in the cardiac muscle is called cardiomyocyte. They are arranged in series and parallel to each other, forming a network in which the fibers branch and combine. The cells are connected to each other at intercalated discs. If we see inside each cell, we can find many similarities between cardiac muscle and skeletal muscle. Like inside the cardiac myocyte, there are multiple myofibrils. These myofibrils contain similar contractile filaments, actin and myosin. Here also, they are arranged in a highly organized fashion, so cardiac muscles also have a striated appearance. Along with this contractile machinery, the myocytes also have T-tubules that invaginate from the membrane to inside the cell. Apart from radial tubules, they also have axial tubules. These T-tubules help spread the action potential from the surface to deep inside the cell. This makes the excitation-contraction coupling faster. So these were the similarities between skeletal muscle and cardiac muscle. Now, there are some important differences as well. The main one is that the cardiac muscle is a syncytium. In simple words, all the muscle cells are so connected that they behave as a single unit. The reason is the strong connections between all myocytes at intercalated discs. Here, desmosomes connect the adjacent cells mechanically, and high number of gap junctions connect the cells electrically. The gap junctions provide free passage to ions, so the electrical activity passes from one cell to the next very rapidly. Because of this, stimulation of one cell results in a rapid spread of action potential to all other cells. Now, actually, there are two syncytium in the heart. One is the atrial syncytium, which makes the wall of the atria, and the other is ventricular syncytium, which makes the wall of ventricles. They are separated by fibrous tissue called atrioventricular ring. Impulses cannot cross this fibrous tissue. So normally the atrial and ventricular impulses do not mix up. This allows independent contraction of atrial and ventricular muscles. This is very important because for effective pumping, the atria needs to contract first and empty its blood into the ventricle before the ventricle finally pumps all the blood out of the heart. The only point from where the impulse can pass from the atria to the ventricles is by the AV bundle. They take impulses from the SA node to ventricles after a delay to initiate ventricular contraction after atria have emptied their blood into ventricles. Speaking of impulse conduction, the third type of cardiac muscle is specialized excitatory and conductive muscle fibers. They generate impulses or transmit them. Thus, they play an important role in maintaining heart rhythm. They contain few contractile proteins, so they have limited contractility compared to the main atrial and ventricular muscles. So this was the physiological anatomy of cardiac muscles. Now let's have a quick summary. Multiple cardiomyocytes connect at intercalated discs to make cardiac muscle. Inside, they have myofibrils and transverse tubule system, similar to that in skeletal muscle. The special thing is, the large number of gap junctions at the intercalated discs make the cardiac muscle a syncytium. The atrial and ventricular syncytium are separated by fibrous tissue, called the atrioventricular ring. Excitatory and conductive fibers play a role in controlling rhythm and don't participate in the contractile process much. That's it for this video. If you have come this far, please consider supporting me by liking, commenting, and sharing the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.